I count the silent
days. Ramin Karimloo, an internationally celebrated musical star, is best known to many Chinese audiences for his role as the Phantom in the 25th anniversary production of The Phantom of the Opera. After years of eager anticipation by his Chinese fans, Ramin finally brought himself and his talented friends to China earlier this year.
Well, it's intriguing, but to go would cost me greatly. So what percentage of the show would I be taking?
The spectacular concert, titled The Reunion, features Ramin performing on stage along with Samantha Barks, Earl Carpenter, and a select group of artists who are also favorites of London's West End and New York's Broadway. Prior to one of their performances in Shanghai, the three musical actors sat down with me for a discussion about their first trip in China.
How's your trip in China so far?
My husband got to go to the Great Wall of China, and I didn't get to go because I was looking after my baby, who's 3 months. And so that's been really exciting, showing him around Shanghai and Beijing.
What about you, Ramin?
All my days off, it's been nice just to hang out, go to the local gym.
Right, I saw you pumping those weights.
Because I travel so much, I kind of like to not feel like a tourist and make a home from home. Mm-hmm. But I don't stress about it because I know I'm going to come back to China. Now I'll do more touristy stuff when there's a bit more time and a bit maybe more healthy.
What about your coffee adventure?
And it's comprehensive. Mm-hmm. It's getting bigger. The list is getting bigger. This is my fourth time in China, and it was really great knowing that it was their first time here. It was a little apprehensive for them.
So you're kind of like the local expert for them now?
Well, I don't know about that. I think it's certainly...
Are.
Am I? Oh, yes, I am.
Help us, these amazing.
I do this. Yeah. But it's been lovely to come back, and each time it gets easier, simpler, and then you kind of see more things and engage a little more confidently, mm-hmm. you know, and particularly with language and stuff. But it's just been brilliant.
Ramin says the plan to come to China has been incubating for many years, and Earl has been instrumental in making it happen.
Let's talk about the reunion. So I know you've put a lot of work into this concert. How did this idea come about?
I think I should start by saying this because we haven't addressed this in any interview, and Earl and I are such good friends, and he plays a lot of the comedy on stage. But honestly, it's because of Earl we're here. It's because of Earl we have the reunion. Mm-hmm. It's something I thought about, the idea of reunion, because I started traveling a lot more. I didn't want to do concerts on my own anymore, and I didn't want to do concerts with other people telling me, you sing this and you sing with such and such. I only want to work with my friends now. Life's too short. I just want to have fun. I pitched this idea with Earl, and because of Earl, his contact and his passion for creating things, he made this happen. So mm-hmm. it's down to Earl. If it wasn't for him, none of this would be happening. Mm-hmm. And I have forever gratitude for you, because now there's so much that's going to happen with the reunion and my time here in China. So I just want to get that known to everyone that it's because of Uncle Carpenter here.
Let your soul take you where you long to.
For Earl, the reunion concert has an important mission to fulfill.
And again, a big part of the reunion and what was always Ramin's remit. We have an incredible amount of support from China around the world. They support us, they support the musicals that we are in a way that is just incredible. So to be able to come back here and ultimately to build, I mean, the one thing that I think is really important is longevity. It's not about coming here, doing a big show, taking some money and go away. It's about growing and growing and growing. And one of the interesting things that it's always been a part of the reunion is to involve local artists, which is why we have local musicians. Mm-hmm. You know, whereas we could have brought everything over for, and it's kind of not of any interest now. It's about growth. It's about an education for us and an education for artists who want to do more in the way of musicals.
Right, so what is it like working with local artists?
Oh, it's been amazing. It's been so lovely to, like you said, not just bring everybody and all of us arrive together and it's just like this bubble. It's lovely that we get to be a part of something here and we get to meet local musicians and get to create the show together. And that's really special for us, really exciting to get to do that.
We had a mad idea of using The Greatest Showman, but having all the big, great big Chinese drums doing it, and I would just love to have that type of involvement.
Obviously, it's my first time here, our first time here, so it would have been almost disingenuous to kind of like just ask any Chinese artist to join us when we don't have a relationship yet. But now we're meeting and I've met some artists. I'm like, okay, next time we come, can we get them involved? Can we collaborate? And we can start building the reunion here.
One day more, tomorrow you'll be miles away.
In terms of the music selection, we have some really well-known classic from Les Mis and Phantom of the Opera, but you're also introducing some of the musicals that have never been performed here. So what's the thought of putting those into the selection?
Speaking for me personally, I am getting to sing On My Own, which is a song that I've sang for years and is so special for me to sing, and I love singing it. But it's also really nice to introduce new songs that maybe people haven't heard before, like Waitress. Waitress is a favorite musical of mine, and I think it's the first time it's been performed in China, isn't it, what Baking Can Do? And that is really exciting as well, because I know for me, when I go and see an artist that I like, I do like to see their classic things that I want to see, but I also like to be introduced to new stuff, and I feel like I get to do something from Frozen, I get to do something from Les Mis, and then Waitress, which is not a show I've done before, but it's nice for me to be bringing it to China and getting to experience it together.
It would be very easy for us to do all the standards, but I think also from our perspective, and it's a bit selfish, but when you have been doing the standards for years and years, it is nice to be able to kind of perform something a little different, something that we might not know, so we still have that kind of, ooh, we don't know it, but I do think it is important to. There are some incredible musicals, not just from an English perspective. You know, there are some incredible musicals that grew out of Germany, and there's lots of stuff that we could be doing, and that's of great interest, and particularly if we start involving kind of artists from here. I mean, I know that there are quite a few Chinese translations of certain musicals, which would be good for us to maybe knuckle down and learn a song or two in Chinese.
How would you describe the audience here?
Oh, insane.
It's been incredible. The Chinese audience are sophisticated. They know musicals. The reaction they're getting that blew me away is for Gentleman's Guide, our second song.
Yeah.
And for Dr. Zhivago, it's just as big as Phantom. Now, of course, Phantom has, in Les Mis, are the calling card. It's something we all grown up with and love. But that serves maybe 20 minutes of a show tops. So it's not hard to kind of like offer something new, because I think the audience, one, are smarter than people give audiences credit for. They've supported theater, and not just in China, no matter where we go. And an audience loves to see an artist having the best time. Mm. So when an audience sees an artist having a good time, they come for the ride too.
One day more, another day, another destiny. This never-ending road to Calvary. These men who seem to know my crime will surely come a second time.
When it comes to the role of musicals in modern society, Ramin, Samantha, and Earl share common belief. They see musicals as nourishment for the soul.
Unfortunately, with social media and the way how fast the world is now, you get less and less being present. I'm guilty of that too, which is why, like, for me, I started meditating and whatnot, and then that's why I love doing these shows, because for that moment, you're present there. And I think as an audience member, that's important because people need to be present, people need to challenge their ideas, to grow, to learn, to be entertained, to cry, because there's nothing wrong with that, to laugh. And I think the arts offers that, and it gives us a moment to think about things in life, and depending on what the piece is, and if it's an expression of an experience, something happening in the world, or just stupid fun entertainment, all that's great, and all that's valid.
I remember I had a really good friend who played the piano, and I remember them just getting up and playing the piano. We were away, and it was amazing how the whole bar turned around and was so happy about the music, but everyone spoke different languages, and just it united and brought everyone together. I remember thinking that's really powerful to be able to play an instrument like that.
And I think that's exactly what Sam said as well. It's music does unite, and I think at the heart of the reunion, it's not just the case of reuniting us, reuniting with the audiences, but it gives the audience a moment through the noise, and I think absolutely spot on there with, it is so noisy, but I think music just puts the brake on and allows you a moment to kind of just be in a world that actually is how it should be. And I'm hoping that what we're doing now here and what we will be doing with the reunion, hopefully internationally, will just give some people that moment to be able to just to relax and to stop and actually, you know.
Enjoy the moment.
There's a lot of things that aren't that important.
For this moment, we're all unified.
As the show comes to an end, it was clear that this concert had been more than just a musical spectacle. It was a heartwarming reunion, uniting artists, fans, and cultures through the universal language of music. Lin Lin, CGTN.